So good morning all. So biological neurons and artificial neurons. So introduction to ANN structure. In this, we discuss about the definition of neural network. So what is the definition of neural network? A neural network is a machine. It's a machine that is designed to model the way in which the brain performs. That means a neural network is a machine, so that is going to behave like brain. It performs a particular task. A network is usually implemented by using electronic components or is simulated in software on a digital computer. That means, so this machine, the neural network machine, is going to perform a particular task. So for example, so rainfall prediction. So now, so how your brain can predict the rainfall in similar way? So based on some input, if this machine will also predict the rainfall. That means that rainfall ANN model, you are design a rainfall ANN model. So this model is going to perform a particular task. The task is, so predicting rainfall detection as rainfall prediction. Okay. So now this ANN is designed with electronic components, or you are going to simulate this by using softwares. Now you all are understand ANN is a machine. It works like brain and it performs a particular task, and it is implemented by using some electronic components, or it is simulated in software. So after that, we discuss about the benefits of neural network. So what are the benefits you have when you design or when you create a neural network model? So non-linearity. So non-linearity means at the end of the day, it sends some results that is not linear. So that means it does not send any summation. It sends some prediction that we are called as a non-linearity. And input and output mapping. So there are two types of learning methodologies. One is supervised learning and unsupervised learning. So that is the benefit of neural network. And adaptivity, by using the synaptic weights. And next one, evidential response. So that means it's a decision with a measure of confidence. So contextual information and fault tolerance. And VLSI implementability and uniformity of analysis and design, and so neurobiological analogy. So these are the benefits of ANN. Okay. So after we discuss about the human brain. So how the human brain means, this is the block diagram of human brain. So these are the receptors. So this is the neural net, and these are the effectors. So based on this, we get some response. So this is the block diagram representation of nervous system. This is also we discussed in our previous class. So receptors can receive the input from the external environment, and so by using these neural network, it can affect the other neurons and we get some response. And so finally we discuss about, so human is faster than computer. Why? Even though the computers works on 10 power minus 9 seconds, it can execute 10, it can execute the instructions in this speed 10 power minus 9 seconds, but the human neuron can process the data 10 power minus 3 seconds. But why? So human is faster. In that class we conclude this. So why? Human is faster than the machine. So means, so because the brain consists of some massively parallel network of neurons. So more than 10 billion so neurons are in your brain. All these neurons are some massively parallel network. That means all these neurons are connected each other. And that connections, maybe it are more than 60 trillion interconnections are there. So that's why even the speed of the neuron, the processing speed of the neuron is 10 power minus 3. But the human brain is fast because of this parallel network, so between the neurons. In today's class, so we are going to discuss about pyramidal cell. So this is the neuron. Let us assume this is the neuron. So this is the neuron. So how it is, take the input and how it generates the output. Okay. If you observe that, so this is the cell body. So this is the cell. This pyramidal cell can receive 10,000 or more synaptic contacts. So these are the synaptic contacts. If you observe that these are the synaptic, so these are the synaptic contacts. The pyramidal cell can receive 10,000 or more synaptic contacts, and it can project onto thousands of target cells. Now this can target to another cells. So this can target another cells. A synapse is simple connection. If you observe, these are the synapses. These are the synapses. A synapse is a simple connection that can impose execution or inhibition, but not both on the receptive neuron. So receptive neuron is nothing but, for example, here it can receive the input from one synapse. Now it takes the input from this and it generates the output, and it is send this output to another neuron. And here if you observe, these are the lines. So these are the lines. These are the, we are called as a axons. So what is the axons? Is nothing but axons are the transmission lines. So these axons are the transmission lines. So these are the axons. If you observe, this is the axon. So what is the purpose of the axon? Means axons are the transmission lines. And coming to dendrites. If you observe, these are the dendrites. So dendrites receives input from another neurons. These are the dendrites. So these dendrites receives input from other neurons. It takes the input from other neurons through a web of input terminals or branches. So there are many neurons. I hope you all are understand the brain is consists of neurons, and all the neurons are massively and parallelly interconnected. Now, so these dendrites receive the input from other neurons through a web of input terminals or branches. So this is very important question. So regarding your final exam also, this is the pyramidal cell, and the pyramidal cell can receive 10,000 or more synaptic contacts. These are the synaptic contacts. And it can project onto thousands of target cells. Now these are the transmitting to many cells. A synapse is a simple connection that can impose execution or inhibition, but not both, on the receptive neuron. And axons are the transmission line. These are the axons. So these are the transmission lines. Just wait. Okay. So these are the synaptic terminals. The synapse is a simple connection that can impose execution on other neurons. And these dendrites, so receives the information from another neurons. Okay. So this is about the pyramidal cell. The same thing here. So what we discussed up to now, the pyramidal cell can receive the 10,000 or more synaptic contacts, and it can project onto thousands of target cells. A synapse is a simple connection that can impose acceleration or inhibition, but not both, on the receptive neurons. That means, for example, this is the neuron. The synapse can impose acceleration or inhibition. That means it can take the information from this neuron, or it can input this neuron, but not both on the receptive neuron. That means it can take the input from this neuron, or it stores the output onto the neuron. And axons are the transmission lines. And dendrites receives input from other neurons through a web of input terminals or branches. Okay, so this is about the pyramidal cell. So next one, structure, organization of levels in the brain. So structural organization of levels in the brain, how the brain's organizing. So this is the molecules. So molecules connected with synapses. So synapses, the neural micro circuits. So this is the circuits. So these more as a dendrite trees. So dendrite trees with neurons. So neurons with local circuits, and local circuits are integrational circuits are connected as central nervous system. Just wait. Okay, that means the molecules forms the synapses. Different synapses we form neural micro circuits, and these circuits are connected with dendrite trees, and these dendritic trees are connected with neurons, and neurons are connected with local circuits. So local circuits are connected with interregional circuits, and these club together called as a central neural system. This is the structural organization of levels in the brain. So molecules, synapses, the neural microcircuits, dendritic trees, so neurons, local circuits, interregional circuits, central nervous system. So next, biological neurons and artificial neurons. So what is biological neurons and what is artificial neurons? I hope you all are understand the biological neurons. So here, if you take this example, it's a pyramidal cell. So this is one neuron. But coming to artificial neurons, so how we are going to construct the artificial neurons? Artificial neural network so tries to approximate the structure of human brain and are fed with amount of data to learn. So what it means, so how the human brain, for example, this is the neuron. So this neuron is connected with many other neurons, and this neuron also take the input from the external environment. Now, so this is it takes the input, and it takes the input from many directions, from another neurons, and it takes the information externally, and it takes the input from another neurons in the brain. So now, and similarly, so this is the input. So this is the input and this is the output. And similarly, this is the input to this neuron and it generates some output. Okay, now, so artificial neural network tries to approximate the structure of human brain, the same structure you are going to develop as a artificial neural network. So artificial neural network tries to appropriate the structure of human brain and are fed with the amount of data to learn. Now in this neurons, you are going to feed some information or you are going to store some data. Okay. Now, so neural network architecture is arranged into layers. So, okay, that means artificial neural network, so you are going to design in this architecture. This architecture is organized into layers. So where each layer consists of many simple processing units called nodes. So further connected to several nodes in the layer above and below it. So what it means that, so for example, so this is the brain. So these are the neurons. Let us, you take the input, generate some output. So these are sent to another neuron. So these neurons also generate some output that is transmitting to different neurons. Okay. So now, this architecture is arranged into layers. If you observe that, so this is the first layer. Let us assume layer 1, layer 2, layer 3. Similarly, if you have different networks, architecture, this is the layer 4, let us assume. That means if you construct, here we are going to construct a ANN architecture like this. So neural network architecture is arranged into layers, where each layer consists of many simple processing units. Here the processing unit is 1. Here the processing units are 2. Here the processing units are 4. Here the processing units are 3. So where each layer consists of many simple processing units called nodes. These we are called as a nodes. So further connected to several nodes. This node is connected. So this node is connected with these two nodes in the layer above and below it. So these two nodes are connected with below these node and above with these four nodes. Okay. So this is the diagrammatic representation. So input 1, input 2, input N, and this is the neuron. So this is the output and connected with many other neurons. Okay. Here we see the pyramidal structure. So pyramidal cell. So pyramidal cell. Now the same structure that is equivalent to electrical model. So model of ANN. So this is very important topic. If you understand this model of ANN, so this is the very important question regarding your final exam also. So model of ANN, the same model you are going to follow in our future units also. Units you are going to discuss so different concepts. In all these concepts you are going to use the same model. Okay, so try to understand this model, then it is very easy to understand further classes. So this is the equivalent electrical model to the human brain. So it is a model, structural model we follow. Okay, so this is the equivalent electric model to the our brain system. So this is the model of ANN here. So this is the summation junction, called as a summation junction. It takes input from different signals. This is the x1 x2 x3 xn. Here these W's are weights. Now, so this is the summation. So these signals here, you are going to find the summation. What is the summation? The net signal at neuron. So this is the artificial neuron. It takes the input from input as a input signals. The input signal is X1, W1. So X1 is the signal. So W is the weight. Here the X2 is the signal, W2 is the weight. Now, so these are sent to on neuron. So this neuron we are called as a summing junction. That means it receives all the signals. So we write here sigma. So this is the sigma. Now, so for the sigma, you are going to use some bias to adjust this summation. So this bias is also sent to this summation junction. So now here we are going to use some activation function. The activation function, so psi. So why we use this activation function means, so we want a non-linear answer here. So if you are using the summation, let us assume, so these are the input lines, for example 2, 3, 5. So summation is nothing but 2 plus 3 plus 5. That means we got 10. But actually, by using these ANN model, you are going to predict some results. You are going to predict or you are going to analysis, so based on the previous values. Here 2, 3, 5 is going to, so find some facts. So these values you are going to use to find some facts. So for example, rainfall prediction. So for rainfall prediction, you are going to take the rainfall for all the 12 months. All the 12 months for last 10 years, let us assume. Last 10 years. So based on these numbers, you are going to predict yes or no. Or there is a heavy rainfall, or there is no rainfall, you can predict. So these type of answers. So we don't want the summation. So here you are going to write one activation function. So this results some non-linear answers, and this is the output of this function. Okay. I hope you all are understand model of ANN. Model of ANN is nothing but takes the input, and summing junction is nothing but that's a neuron, and that the input is stored, and by using some activation function, you are going to find some, you are going to predict some non-linear output. I hope you all are understand the application of ANN. The application of ANN is, the first application is the benefit of first. The first benefit of ANN is, so non-linear, it's a non-linear. So what is a non-linear means? Actually, we don't want any summation here. We want some prediction of data. From fact, we are going to predict some fact from the input data. So that we are going to find with the help of activation function. So you all are remember that. So any ANN model is like this only. Any ANN model. You remember this diagram? So input signals. Input signal is the combination of inputs and weights. So these are the weights. So now these are sent to neuron. So this neuron we are called as a summing junction. That means it receives the data. It receives the data. And by applying some activation function on the result, we get a nonlinear output. Remember these four steps. So input lines, the summation function, and the activation function, and output. And here you are going to give one bias to this neuron. Okay. Now you say that the net signal at neuron. So what is the net signal here? The net signal is x1w1 plus x2w2 plus xnwn. And this is a linear summation. But we want some decision as the output. Okay. So rainfall prediction is nothing but we are going to find some decision. So based on the input, if you are not using this function, then we get some summation only. If that output is different of what is desired, then change the strength or weight. Okay. So already we discussed about the synaptic weight. So these are the weights. If we get if we get the output that is different from our desired output, then you are going to change these weights. Okay. So Lokesh, G4. So all these are the ICs. So these are the already we discuss in our previous classes. So all these neurons designed with the help of silicon ICs. So these are the silicon ICs with the speed 10⁻⁹ seconds. So these silicon ICs we are used as a neurons in ANN, artificial neural network. Lokesh, are you understand which data structure used in ANN? Here the data structure is, these are the models. ANN itself is a model. It's artificial neural network model. In this, we have different types of models. And why the data is transmitting very fast means, so here the neurons are created with the help of silicon ICs. So the speed of the silicon ICs is 10⁻⁹ seconds. It's a nanosecond. It is going to perform the operations. So what is the purpose of the bias means? Just wait. So this is the BIOS. The purpose is it's a electric component. Now it is also some disadvantages. Now for example, it receives the input signal. So because of any external sources, the signal will be low. Then so that can be improved or that can be managed with the help of BIOS by adding these BIOS to this summation. Okay, so I hope in future classes you are going to understand about this BIOS. So because these are the electric components, so these electric components receives the electric signals. So these signals will be so down, these signals will be so weak, then so this will be equalized with the help of BIOS. So BIOS is used for equalizing the signal. Okay, so anybody have any doubts? Okay, so everyone please try to understand this model of ANN. It is very important. The model of ANN is a consists of one neuron. This is the neuron. So this neuron takes the input signals and weights x1 w1, x2 w2, x3 w3, xn wn. Sorry. Now, so this BIOS can equalize these input signals, and the summing function returns some output, that is UK. Now, by using some activation function, you are going to predict some output. The net signal at neuron is so x1 plus w1, x2 plus w2, x3 plus w3, xn plus wn. Okay, so that is a net signal at neuron here. This is a linear summation. So what we get in this sigma? Sigma is nothing but linear summation. 2 plus 3 plus 5 means it returns 10. Why? Because here you are using the summation. But we want some decision as an output. No? So rainfall prediction. So we want some decision. We don't want the summation of last 10 years data. We want the predict that so this month, April, so heavy rainfall or normal rainfall or there is no rainfall. So this is the decision we want. So you are going to use some activation function here. If the output is, sorry, this activation function returns some decision only. Okay. If the output is different of what we desire, then the change the strength of weight. That means, for example, April, if we get the heavy rainfall, this is not the desired result. So you are going to change these weights. Okay, this is the ANN model.